perhaps for Greeks and for Greece, this may be more important, and we can feel the importance of Brexit also in relation to international affairs and neighborhood issues that we have. It seems that today or nowadays the issues are much more emphatic, but this may have been the case also in many points in time in the past. I want us to offer you, if you want, two questions to set out the dimensions of the issue, and then I will introduce the speakers, the panelists, and say a couple of words about what they will cover it. I think one way of looking at the question of Brexit is to ask what it means in terms of what it shows on the, if you want, the beliefs, expectations of the public, of the electorate, both in Britain and in the rest of the European Union. So do Europeans lose their identity, or is the European identity somehow altered by the prospective exit of non-participation, if you want, of Britain into the European Union? But also, more importantly perhaps, what is the self-perception of British people in Britain? What does the Brexit vote signal, and also how the Brexit itself will affect the identity in this island. The second dimension of Brexit, however, has to do not with the perception about Europeanness or Britishness, but actually with the living conditions and opportunities of people, obviously both in Europe and in Britain. And for what concerns perhaps this gathering today, also for Greeks. And I think here we have at least two important dimensions. One dimension is economic, and I think a lot of attention has been given to the economic dimension. Will Britain be able to strike new trade deals with the rest of the world that will be more beneficial, that will generate more jobs, growth, regulatory issues? Will Britain be more independent to decide on different sets of regulations for trade standards, for employment standards, environmental standards, and so forth. And also, of course, will Europe be affected by the departure of the exit of Britain from the European Union? Will the European economy suffer from this? But I think more important perhaps is the geopolitical dimension. There has been historically quite a few differences of opinion between the, as we call it, the continent and Britain on foreign policy issues, on big questions about whether the European Union needs to have a common defense policy and a common army. So there has been many disagreements in the past. However, the participation of Britain in the European project and in the European Union, as it became more and more institutionalized and integrated, has strengthened the European Union. It has strengthened the European Union politically, geopolitically, in terms of trade negotiations, in terms of prestige, even in terms, if you want, for with regard to cultural diplomacy, or the influence of arts and arts, theater, and so forth, have on global culture. So the what we call soft power that the European Union may be able to exert after the exit of Britain may be somewhat compromised, even though Britain was not the most significant contributor to the soft power of the European Union while it was a member. So that may have been a long introduction. I hope I haven't bored you too much. So I think there's wider economic and geopolitical issues that are obviously at stake. And the issues are not only questions of identity and belonging, but they also concern, they have consequences for individuals living here, living in Europe, and of course, as part of Europe, living also in Greece. I think we will be able to touch upon some of these dimensions, in part through the contributions of the panelists, but perhaps more fully in the question and answer session that will follow the presentations. I have to say that our first panelist, Joe Moore, will have to leave early with apologies, so we'll start with his presentation. We will open up for maybe two or three questions, then we'll have to excuse him, and then we'll continue with the other presentations. We can pick up the points, some of the points from the early discussion also at the last session of the Q&A. So without further ado, let me say a few words for our speakers, and I'll pass the floor to them. So immediately to my left, government parks in transit property and parks in judicial review. He's regularly invited to comment on tax issues by political broadsheets, magazines, and TV, including Financial Times, BBC, Pax Journal, and others. He has an LLB in European Legal Studies from the University of Dara and an MA in Modern Literature from Belgrade College in London. He has started the Council's Equality and Diversity Committee for a number of at the Bar Council's Equality and Diversity Committee for a number of years, and he lectures on rights, value, and tax policy matters. After Mom's presentation of the sort of Q&A, we will pass the floor to the second speaker, Nikos Konstantaras, who I imagine many of you know well. He's a columnist for the newspaper Kathimerini and a contributing op-ed writer for the New York Times International Edition. He's the founding editor of Kathimerini's English edition, which is published as a supplement of the New York Times and Business Insiders, and he edited it from 1998 to 2017. He was managing editor of the Greek edition of Kathimerini from 2004 to 2017 as well. He studied ancient Greek in South Africa and worked as a correspondent for the Associated Press in Athens in 1989-1997. Last but not least, at the very end of the table, my colleague Vicky Price, a leading economist and board member at the Center for Economic and Business Research. At various stages in her career, she has held a number of economic positions in the banking and the oil sector. She was previously Senior Managing Director at FTI Consulting, Director General for Economics at the Department for Business Innovation and Skill, PIS, the UK government, joint head of the UK government economic service. She has also held a number of academic posts as visiting professional fellow in various UK universities. Most famously, perhaps to the Greeks, she's author of a book, Greekonomics, which discusses the crisis in the Euro and about a Greek exit, which now seems hugely unlikely. A Greek exit from the European, from the Eurozone might mean, obviously, for the country. So our panelists will take around 10 to 15 minutes for the contributions, and as I said, we'll open